Y'all can't imagine how many days I've waited for Nikita Dragon to be humbled and embarrassed in public by a celebrity. I guess all my wishes came true. I'm low-key thinking of throwing a party right now, because I think that Nikita Dragon getting humbled by a freaking A-list celebrity is what we have all been asking for. Seriously, this Nikita girl has been treating herself as if she's some kind of celebrity, and the fact that she goes around on social media making statements about how she isn't an influencer is just ridiculous. Like, it's giving very much, I'm embarrassed to be an influencer now. You know what I'm saying? If we go back exactly 2 months ago, you guys, my girl Nikita was starting a huge war on Twitter after she made a controversial statement saying, influencers are the new celebrities. And the reason why she made this statement was not only to talk about herself, but instead she was actually defending Addison and Dixie by calling them celebrities after they received backlash for getting invited to the Met Gala. Yeah. None of them ended up giving any attention to Nikita either way, so. With that being said, Nikita continued making controversial remarks about the situation as she started calling herself a model as well. And not gonna lie, I do agree in some parts that she is really good at modeling, but definitely not a celebrity. Like, girl, sit down, please. Anyways, the reason why I'm mentioning this whole narrative of Nikita acting as a celebrity is because just recently, the one and only Cardi B herself decided to invite Nikita Dragon to her birthday party. And of course, you would think that Nikita was probably living this fantasy of her being so important to society now that she's getting invitations by A-list celebrities. But unfortunately, things didn't end up going very well for my girl Nikita. Since a video of her getting ignored by Cardi B for a hot minute at her birthday party went viral. Just check this out.
Stop it. So that's it now. That's it now.
Not only did people turn their backs at Nikita during the entire party, but she even seemed a bit upset and embarrassed that no one was giving her the attention she was asking for, including Cardi B herself. And that's why a lot of people took to Twitter to make fun of Nikita Dragon for finally getting humbled after thinking she is a celebrity now. I hope she finally realizes she's not a celebrity. LMAO. She's standing there desperately trying to look for someone familiar. Like, no, I'm sorry, you're not relevant, honey. Bruh, she's standing there like me looking for my grandma in the grocery store. People were really on her neck, not gonna lie, but I can't pretend that Nikita isn't the type of person who hangs out with Demi Lovato and calls herself a celebrity after. Anyways, y'all, let's keep today's video going with Blake Gray, who's apparently terrified to look Bryce Hall in the eyes. Hear me out, I totally understand where Blake is coming from and the reason why he won't look Bryce in the eyes, but come on. How TF are you terrified of Sid from Ice Age? Maybe there's a secret behind why everyone doesn't involve themselves with Bryce anymore. Because I low-key have a feeling that he's the type of guy who starts drama with anyone just to be on the news and then pretend it didn't happen. And, maybe this is one of the reasons why Blake isn't involving himself with Bryce anymore. Literally, ever since the Sway House got separated and both Blake and Bryce had some beef on the internet, a lot of people took sides with Bryce as if he was the innocent guy who got left alone by the Sway House members. But no one really questioned why they left him in the first place.
I feel like everyone's noticed that the like Sway boys don't even like hang out anymore. I'm like cool with everyone. It's just the tension between Noah, Blake, and I. Just,
it's too much.
Yeah, it's weird.
I mean, even though the Sway boys had a reunion after, none of them really seemed comfortable being around each other, specifically Blake and Bryce, who were throwing shade left and right at each other the night before. It's just so awkward to even think about it, but it's literally been, what, a couple of months since that happened? And just recently, Bryce decided to throw shots at Blake Gray again for no reason in his newest YouTube video, after he revealed that Blake refuses to look him in the eye when they see each other in public.
Why won't Blake look at
me? I don't know. I mean, I'm scared. I'm his roommate and I said what up to you.
I know you are and so did Markel, but why is he so scared to even like look at me? Blake, it's so easy. Like, I don't understand why it's so hard to just come up to somebody.
Shortly after this happened, you guys, Blake Gray's girlfriend, Amelie Ziebler, made a decision to unfollow Bryce on Instagram for good, since he was going around throwing shade at her boyfriend after months of being on good terms. And y'all, that was a officially the moment where Bryce had a full-on meltdown on social media, since he decided to repay the favor to Amelie by unfollowing her on Instagram as well. He even went on Twitter to throw a couple of hints at us by claiming that people go through phases, and him getting unfollowed by his ex-friends is nothing serious. It's so funny to me that this generation's way of determining whether a friendship slash relationship is over or not is by an Instagram unfollow. I love being trapped in this internet high school universe. And no matter how many times it's been proven that I never lie or fabricate my situations, I will still always be the bad guy once again. I have nothing to hide and I will never live by the clean fame BS. This could just be Bryce trying to tell us that his relationship with Blake and Amelie is not determined by a follow button and that they could be friends privately. But a lot of people felt that Bryce was doing too much about the whole situation since he seemed to be victimizing himself again and again and again. Is he victimizing himself? Why even bring Blake up in the first place though? He knows how the internet is. All he does is beef people, and people had the audacity to say Addison was the problem. Speaking of my queen, Addison Rae, did y'all know that there is a rising pop star who's not only coming to end her career, but all these TikTokers' singing careers? Bella Poarch, honey? You better watch out. Can y'all really guess which TikToker became a singer? I can give y'all a hint and say that it is probably the most random TikToker you'll ever think of. Because how the hell did he become a singer too? It's becoming ridiculous in my opinion, because the amount of suffering and trauma we've had from these TikTok songs is enough for us. Personally, I just think that the influencer industry is unpredictable nowadays, because these influencers can go from being actual influencers to literally modeling, singing, acting, and even directing movies. And guess what's the craziest part about this? Yep, some of them even succeeded with their new career path. You guys might as well expect me to drop a song very soon. This fellow TikToker that we're gonna talk about has already dropped a song before a couple of months ago, but it didn't really gain all the attention he expected to receive, since many people were able to notice that he didn't really seem passionate about his music career. Although, he recently announced that he will be releasing another song, you guys, and it's called Screaming Underwater. Alex Warren, the most random TikToker you can ever think of, is now turning his YouTube career to a singing career. And he low-key seems more serious and passionate about it now than before. Because about a week ago, Alex decided to duet a TikTok video of a guy promoting his music by talking about how good his voice actually is. And, he also slipped a bit of shade towards TikTokers getting all the attention for their music instead of him, such as Dixie D'Amelio, Addison Rae, and Bella Poarch, who got all people's eyes on their music.
Addison Rae has a song. Dixie D'Amelio has a song. Bella Poarch has a song.
But what if I were to tell you there's a massive TikTok that also makes music?
It sounds like a mixture of Lewis Capaldi, Ed Sheeran, and Dean Lewis.
Talking about Alex Warren. Oh, wait. I'm talking about Alex Warren.
That's right, the massive YouTuber from the Hype House.
Despite Alex being completely honest about his opinion towards TikTokers gaining more attention than him, I do think his music is good and enjoyable, all jokes aside, because not only does he open up about serious issues and struggles in his songs, like Bella Poarch, but he also doesn't force his music on anyone. He just seems to be enjoying making music as a side part of his career. With that being said, here's what people had to say about Alex's music. You deserve it. You have great music. You don't make music, bro. You make art. Anyways, loves, don't forget to leave all your opinions on Alex's music down below and whether you like it or not. I love you so much.